They've been marching and protesting for days. Students, teachers, and administrators of state universities and colleges are denouncing the government, saying it is not prioritizing education. But President Aquino himself has said that education is high among the priorities of this new administration. The palace says it is willing to talk to the protesting students, but admits this may be easier said than done.
Babalik po yan doon sa kabukasan ng ating pag-iisip at pag-iintindi. Kung mahirap naman din po kasi kahit po mag-explain tayo ng mahaba, kung hindi naman pong bukas na makinig, mahihirapan naman din po tayo.
In 2010, then-President Gloria Arroyo approved a 21 billion peso budget for state universities and colleges. This was in principle increased to 23.84 billion pesos through congressional insertions. These insertions were vetoed by Mrs. Arroyo until the government finds additional revenues. For 2011, the Aquino administration is proposing a 23.4 billion peso budget for SUCs. But while the overall SUC budget was increased, cuts were made in some state universities, including the University of the Philippines, the Philippine Normal University, the Aurora State College of Technology, the J.H. Sarile State College, and the University of Southeastern Philippines. Lawmakers and the budget chiefs say it's time that state universities and colleges help themselves by leasing land, renting out space, and engaging in some commercial activities. But protesting state universities and colleges say it is and will remain the duty of government to help them.
The Philippines has more than 100 state universities and colleges, most of them dependent on support from government. For weeks now, the debates have been raging on the budget for state universities and colleges next year. Today on Talkback, we will set the record straight, or so we hope. Was the budget for SUCs cut? Is the government right in asking SUCs to seek self-supporting ventures? And will state universities and colleges open their books and reveal their earnings? Our question, should state universities and colleges utilize their assets, underutilized assets, so they say, to augment their budget? You can join our discussion. Text us, react, space, ANC space, with your name, address, and message. Then send to 2331 for Globe, Touch Mobile, Bayan, and Sun subscribers, and 231 for Smart and Talk and Text subscribers. And send us your tweets at twitter.com/ANC alerts, and be a fan of Talkback with Tina Palma on Facebook. With us, the newly elected president of the University of the Philippines. He will assume the post in February, Alfredo Pascual. Congratulations, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us. Also with us is the president of the Polytechnic University of the Philippines, PUP, and one of the officials of the Philippine Association of State Universities and Colleges, Dr. Dante Guevarra. It's good to see you, doctor. And we also have the executive director of the Commission on Higher Education, Lito Vitriolo. Thank you so much for joining us, gentlemen.
Hello.
We will begin by getting a statement from CHED. Is the budget that is being talked about now of the state colleges or the state universities and colleges of 24 billion pesos for this year a budget that is lower or higher from the previous 2010 budget?
Okay, if we look at the 2010 National Expenditure Program, which was actually the one proposed by the Executive Department in Congress, the 2011 NEP or National Expenditure Program is higher by around 700 million. But let me qualify that. While it is higher, it is due to the increase in the personal services due to the implementation of the second tranche of the salary standardization law. However, the MOE or the maintenance operations and other expenditures or expenses of the SUCs the budget ceiling was actually reduced by 5%. So this is around 110 million. But there is a net increase, of course, if you look at the totals. But the effect of the 110 million decrease for some SUCs, there was a cut in their operating expenditures.
Okay. You're a finance person from what I read. Is this a matter of financial jargon, or in real numbers, the budget was reduced only in these areas, or in its totality, sir?
Well, for UP, we're autonomous, so we get lump sum allocation. On the overall, NEP 2010 to NEP 2011, there was a slight increase due exactly to what Attorney Vitriolo is explaining. And this is due to the implementation of the SSL 2, second tranche.
The salary standardization law.
Yes, yes. Now, the question is, what are the appropriate numbers to compare?
Yes.
The ultimate number that comes out of the government, executive and legislative taken together, is the GAA.
The General Appropriations
Act.
Act.
And under the General Appropriations Act for UP, for example, in 2010, we got 6.9. But in the NEP proposed for 2011, which will eventually become the basis of the GAA, it's only 5.5. So there is a difference of about 1.4 billion. But of course, the budget is still going to go through the BICOM.
Yes.
And we have been given promises that additions will be made to the NEP to be able to come up with a higher figure for GAA compared to the proposed NEP.
So when you talk of whole of the whole amounts, the 5.5 billion, mm-hmm. that is already a reduced amount from a 6.9 billion you had in 2009 and in 2009.
Yeah, the GAA for 2010 is 6.9.
Yes.
But the NEP for 2011 is 5.5. So there is a 1.4 roughly reduction.
Okay, the reduction was on what particular budget?
There are three items.
Yes.
Okay. There is a slight reduction in the, if you're looking at the GA, it's a major reduction in MOOE and a full removal of any allocation for capital outlay.
For CAPEX?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. But you and the earnings that you have now over the area that you have leased or entered mm-hmm. into a partnership with the Ayalas does not form part of your income, which can be used for UP?
Theoretically,
UP as far as CAPEX and OPEX is concerned?
Theoretically, we can use these additional revenues
yes.
for those purposes. But the thing is...
You don't want to use it and you want to get your share from the national government.
Yeah, and let me explain why.
Yes.
Under the 208 budget of UP, we're supposed to be a research university. And in fact, for UP to be a world-class university, it has to strengthen its research capability. And in our